Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the 47th annual Southern Huntington County Community Choir Concert, a concert given to the glory of God, given with the hearts and the minds and the souls of those who enjoy singing the gospel to those who enjoy receiving the gospel. This year's title is Christmas Changes Everything. Just a reminder, to a world that is so horribly broken, Christmas does change everything. Bring Christ into the front of your heart. Let him touch your heart. Let him help you receive Jesus through the wonderful people who are prepared so heartily to give to you a chance to hear the gospel in a way that you can't hear it in any way else. Let's pray for just a moment. Almighty and most gracious God, we give you thanks and praise and honor and glory. And we ask, dear Lord, that those who sing today would be anointed by you. That those who hear today would be anointed by you. That we might sing to your glory and might hear to your glory, and that we might above all else receive what you have given us to your glory, Lord. Thank you for this afternoon, and thank you for all those who are here to bring your word in music to us. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord. And all God's people said, amen. Sir, I will turn it over to our choir. Thank you.
We come together as the family of God with our friends and loved ones and our precious children to lift our hearts in worship and celebrate the birth of the one who came that first Christmas, the one who continues to bring joy to our world.
We're gathered here, worship Him, the celebration now begin. The precious babe has come to save, so lift your voices and now proclaim.
Would everyone please stand, if you are able, and let's all sing together. congregation, join us.
Thank you. Yes, Jesus is King. He is the King of glory, the Lion of Judah, the Holy Lamb of God. This sovereign King left his kingdom and entered into our time and space on a miraculous mission of rescue. He knew the price, he knew the cost, but his love for us was so strong and so pure. His God-given, driven, unconditional love changed history forever when he left the splendor of heaven and journeyed to a manger in Bethlehem.
The world would never be the same. The answer to man's greatest need lay in a stable in Bethlehem. This holy child was sent from God to be the door between heaven and earth. No wonder the angels proclaimed glad tidings of great joy. No wonder kings sought to find him and worship him. It truly was a holy night.
Most wonderful time of the year. The sights and sounds of Christmas are everywhere. Most of us have already or will soon be putting up a tree. Some will decorate throughout the house, others will string lights on the outdoor shrubs, or maybe set out a manger scene. Then there are those who will fill up their lawns with all sizes and shapes of objects that, when lit up, can be seen by those on the International Space Station.
Every year, there are certain traditions that we observe. Almost all of us will tune in to watch A Charlie Brown Christmas, It's a Wonderful Life, or White Christmas, or Home Alone. This holiday season, many will watch all 15 new Hallmark Christmas movies. And let's be honest, they all end the same way. One of our favorite Christmas movies is Elf. According to Buddy the Elf, the four main food groups are candy, candy canes, candy corn, and syrups.
The holidays seem to bring a sudden urge for all things loaded with sugar. Even those of us who seldom or never eat sweets find ourselves stuffing our faces with all kinds of cakes, pies, donuts, cookies, and candy. In January, some of us are going to step on the bathroom scale as it reads, "To infinity and beyond."
In the midst of all that will transpire during this delightful season, there is one powerful, all-encompassing truth that shines above it all. Christmas changes everything. The night that Christ was born, God initiated and put into motion his plan to make a way that we could be changed. We could be made new on the inside, that we would know peace and feel God's love and his presence, that we would have purpose and meaning. You see, this child of Bethlehem came to change our direction, to change our desires, and yes, to change our destiny.
Christmas is the season of joy, of singing carols and humming familiar melodies. And yet, for many in this room, the song has a hollow ring to it. Even Christians can lose their joy and lose their way.
My all-time favorite movie is It's a Wonderful Life. For years, I wanted so badly for it to become my kids' favorite. They grew up on the colorful animated VeggieTales, so they had no interest in this old black and white flick, which broke my heart. But one day, I came to the realization that this is how so many of us deal with Jesus. He tenderly calls us to himself, but we aren't interested. Even though Jesus promised to bring peace to our hearts, many of us become disillusioned when we come to realize that he never promised to take away our problems. Jesus promises us peace in spite of our problems, in the midst of our problems. In It's a Wonderful Life, the storms in George Bailey's life brought him to the point that he considered throwing his life away. The storms of life can take their toll on all of us. Some of you may be sitting here right now and you're feeling nothing. No emotion, no peace, no hope. Life has disappointed you, been unfair for no real reason. Maybe you're discouraged, tired and beaten down by the struggles and unanswered questions. You no longer believe that God cares. No longer do you believe in prayer. And maybe you've given up on Jesus. But you know what? He hasn't given up on you. Not a single day, not a single hour has he ever stopped loving you, and he never will. Even when you can't hear his voice or see his hand, he is still standing with his arms wide open, reaching, calling, longing to restore your joy and to make all things new.
All is calm and all is bright everywhere, but in your heart tonight they're singing carols of joy and peace, but you feel too far gone and too far out of reach. Somewhere in your silent night, heaven hears the song your broken heart has cried. Hope is here, just lift your head, for love has come to find you. Somewhere in your silent night, from heaven's height to manger low, there is no distance the Prince of Peace won't go. From manger low to Calvary's hill, when your pain runs deep, His love runs deeper still. He has always loved you, child, and He always will. Somewhere in your silent night, heaven hears the song your broken heart has cried. Hope is here, just lift your head, for love has come to find you. Somewhere in your silent night, lift your head, lift your heart. Emmanuel will meet you where you are. He knows your heart. He came. Somewhere in your silent night, heaven hears the song your broken heart has cried. Hope is here, just lift your head, for love has come to find you. Love will find you. Love will find you.
Thank you.
Christ has come to bring us life. There is hope for every one of us, and hope has a name. Before the foundation of the world, God knew we would need a Savior, we would need a Redeemer. And in the fullness of time, Jesus, the precious Lamb of God, tenderly entered our world in the most simple and lowly way.
It was the greatest demonstration of love that the world had ever known. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, and this Son came as a lamb. He would become the conquering king, but he came as a lamb. He would be King of kings and Lord of lords, but he came as a lamb, and he came for you.
Shepherds came seeking this lamb, and their lives would never be the same. The angelic host formed a choir and sang from the heavenlies. Wise men were wise enough to seek and bow down to this lamb. He came to seek and to save the lost. It's great to know that God so loved the world, but more important to know that God loves you.
Now here it is, many years have passed. They say that his time has come and passed, but I am so glad this truth remains, that you're still the Lamb of God.
John looked over the horizon and saw one walking as no man walked, and he said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. He's still saving. He's still redeeming, and he's still there for you today. Receive him. He will change your life. Time cannot change him. He's still the Holy Lamb of God. The Bible says there is coming a day when the Lamb of God will descend from heaven with a shout, and every person from every tribe and nation who chose to receive God's given gift that first Christmas morn will be forever changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, until that day, the one who was and is to come will still be changing lives. Just as Christmas changed lives 2,000 years ago in that tiny stable, Christmas is still changing lives today, right here, in this moment. Why? Because that little Lamb of Bethlehem, the Holy One, the living, resurrected Savior, is alive, and we are alive because of him. Through the power of the Christ who lives in us, we can change the world around us. When we allow the true message of Christmas to permeate our hearts, we become a divine extension of Jesus' love, and everywhere that Jesus is revealed, lives are forever changed. We who have received the gift of Christmas can no longer keep it to ourselves. The message of hope, the message of love, the message of joy and peace is now up to you and me. So let us be joy to the world. Let us be peace on this earth. Let us share God's love with everyone we meet every day of our lives. May we forevermore be a light to those around us and an anthem of praise to the Savior who was born on Christmas Day.